Hello and welcome back to chapter 3 of Horrid Henry's Hike. I don't think this little boy likes going out very much, do you? Let's find out what happens, shall we? Chapter 3. Horrid Henry slumped miserably in the seat. Boy, would they be sorry when he was gobbled up by goats. Boo-hoo! If only we hadn't gone on that walk in the wilds, Mum would wail. Henry was right. We should have listened to him, Dad would sob. I miss Henry.
And I miss Henry, Peter would howl. I'll never eat goat cheese again, and now it's too late.
And they would all shriek. If only, thought Horrid Henry, that would serve them right. All too soon, Mum pulled into a car park on the edge of a small wood.
Wow, said Perfect Peter. Look, all those lovely trees.
Bet there are werewolves hiding in there, muttered Henry, and I hope they come and eat you.
Mum, squealed Peter, Henry's trying to scare me.
Don't be horrid, Henry, said Mum. Horrid Henry looked around him. There was a gate leading to endless meadows, bordered by hedgerows. A muddy path wound through the trees and across the fields. A church spire stuck up in the distance.
Right, I've seen the countryside. Let's go home, said Henry.
Mum glared at him.
What? Said Henry, scowling.
Let's enjoy this lovely day, said Dad, sighing. So what do we do now? Said Henry.
Walk, said Dad.
Where? Said Henry.
Just walk, said Mum, and enjoy the beautiful scenery.
Ugh, Henry groaned. We're heading off for the lake, said Dad, striding off. I've bought bread and we can feed the ducks.
But Rapper Zapper starts in an hour, tough, said Mum.
Mum, Dad and Peter headed through the gate into the field. Horrid Henry trailed behind them, walking as slowly as he could. Breathe the lovely fresh air, said Mum.
We should do this more often, said Dad.
Henry sniffed. The horrible smell of manure filled his nostrils.
Do you know what manure?
Ew, smelly, said Henry. Peter, couldn't you wait?
Mum, shrieked Peter, Henry called me smelly.
Did not.
Did too.
Did not, smelly.
Wah,
wailed Peter.
Tell him to stop.
Don't be horrid, Henry, screamed Mum. Her voice echoed. A dog walked past her and glared.
Peter, would you rather run a mile, jump a stile, or eat a country pancake? Said Henry sweetly.
Oh, said Peter, I love pancakes, and a country one must be even more delicious than a city one.
Ha ha, crackled Horrid Henry, sticking out his tongue. Fooled you, Peter wants to eat cow parts.
Mum,
screamed Peter. Chapter 4. Henry walked. And walked and walked. His legs felt heavier and heavier and heavier.
This field is muddy, moaned Henry. I'm bored, groaned Henry.
My feet hurt, whined Henry.
Can we go home? We've already walked miles, whinged Henry.
We've been walking for 10 minutes. Said Dad.
Please can we go on walks more often? Said Perfect Peter. Oh, look at those fluffy little sheepies.
Horrid Henry pounced. He was a zombie biting the head off a hapless human.
Aye! Squealed Peter.
Henry! Screamed Mum.
Stop it!
screamed Dad. Or no TV for a week.
When he was king, thought Horrid Henry, any parent who made their children go on a hike would be dumped barefoot in a scorpion-infested desert.
Plod, plod, plod. Horrid Henry dragged his feet. Maybe his horrible, mean parents would get fed up waiting for him and turn back, he thought, kicking some mouldy leaves. Squelch, squelch, squelch.
Oh no, not another muddy meadow.
And then Horrid Henry had an idea. I wonder what will happen in chapter 5. Don't forget to subscribe to find out. See you soon.